Good morning, students. Today we are discussing about the interference pattern due to the wedge-shaped film. So in the last class, we have seen the parallel film. In that, we have seen the condition for constructive and destructive interference. So let us look at the wedge-shaped film today now. Here, this is the plain glass plate and this other plain glass plate. In between, we are keeping the any object which we can find the thickness of the film. Here, the wedge-shaped film defined as the film with zero thickness at one end, progressively increasing to a particular thickness at the other end. Here, the wedge-shaped angle is very small, as a fraction of degree. When this wedge-shaped film is exposed to the monochromatic source of light, then we observe a straight and parallel fringes. So this is the dark fringe, this is the bright fringe. Conjugately, you are getting the straight and parallel fringes. So the procedure here is, when a parallel beam of monochromatic light illuminates the wedge frame from the above, the rays reflected from the two boundary surface will not be parallel and diverge from the point near the film. The path difference between the reflected rays from the lower and upper surface of the air film varies along with the length due to the variation in the film thickness. So that's the reason we are getting the alternate bright and dark fringes on the top surface. And these fringes are said to be the localizer fringes. Let us look at the schematic approach for the wedge shaped film. So the light rays incident like this get reflected and they are transmitted into the thin film. So here at this point it faces the 180 degrees phase shift. The corresponding path difference is lambda by 2. The one thing get reflected and the light is coming from here thin film to the denser medium shifts towards the normal, 1 second away from the normal. This both the two rays get superimposed with each other and produces the constructive and destructive interference. So this is the one more figure which can give the clarity of the superposition of two light rays BC and DE. So at this point it faces the 180 degrees phase shift, whereas this point it does not face any phase change, because when the light is coming from the rarer medium to the denser medium, it suffers a phase change of 180 degrees and corresponding path difference is going to be lambda by 2. Here the phase difference, the interference, the fringes depending on the phase difference of a small air film, how many phase the phase difference between the air film. So the let us recall the last class, the delta is equal to 2 mu t cos of minus lambda by 2. This is the corresponding path difference. If the delta is equal to m lambda, if you equate this, you are going to get the constructive interference condition. If delta is equal to 2 plus 1 to lambda by 2, you are getting the destructive interference. So these are the maxima, the path difference. This one, if you equate with respect to 2m plus 1 to lambda by 2, you are getting the right fringe. If you equate in minimum, so you are going to get 2 mu t cos r is equal to m lambda. Here, mu is the refractive index of the air film, t is the thickness. The cos r is nothing but the angle of refraction from the second medium. M is an integer, lambda is the corresponding wavelength. So this is the practical experimental approach. This is a monochromatic source of light. This is a traveling microscope. There is a glass plate here. This is the wedge shaped film in which you can find the thickness of the film. Here between the two glass plates, we are keeping certain which you can find the thickness of the film. There is a small angle here. That angle is theta is equal to 0 at the end. And the thickness varying uniformly from here to here. So this thing should be placed in the presence of a monochromatic source of light. When you start placing the monochromatic source of light, the light incident from the glass plate gets reflected into the wedge-shaped system. Some part of the light is transmitted, gets reflected. If you observe the reflected light profile, you are observing the consecutive straight and parallel fringes. If you find the separation distance between the any two consecutive fringes, that is said to be the fringe width. So look at this pattern which is observed in the wedge-shaped film, the straight and parallel fringes. See, they are straight and parallel, they are equidistant fringes and they are localized fringes. So if you find any the distance between any two successive fringes, that is defined as the fringe width. So now let us calculate the separation distance thing but the fringe width within the mathematical manner. Let us consider one particular thickness of the film. The condition is equal to 2 mu t cos r is equal to m lambda. Here I am considering that rays are incident normally. So one particular technique film, I got the dark field, 2 mu T1 is equal to M lambda. So next consider to the thickness, this is the condition for the next dark field. If you subtract 2 minus 1, you are going to get the separation distance between the two consecutive fringes, that is AB. So 2 mu T2 minus T1 is equal to lambda, since T2 minus T1 is equal to BC from the above figure, so BC is equal to lambda by 2 mu. Here, the angle theta is very small, so that the tan theta is approximately is equal to theta. So from this the final equation, we can write that as the theta is increases, the fringes move closer and closer, and if theta become 90 degrees, the interference pattern is going to be vanishes. So one more important point here is the fringe pattern observed at this point is said to be the apex is going to be dark because the thickness is going to be zero. So delta is equal to 2 mu t cos m minus lambda by 2. If substitute t is equal to 0, delta is equal to lambda by 2. That is a condition for dark fringe. And one more important point is here the fringes are localized fringes. So we can see that all the fringes pattern should be formed on the surface of the glass plate. So this is the fringe at the apex point is the dark, so you have seen just now. And they are straight and parallel fringes because each fringe pattern produced with interference of reflective rays from the section of the wedges have the same thickness. Locus of points having the same thickness lie along lines parallel to the contact edge. So they are straight and parallel fringes. And they are equidistant because beta is equal to lambda by 2 theta. Here lambda is a constant and the wedge shape and angle is also constant, so that for a given wedge angle they are equal, that they are equal space distances. So they are fringes of equal thickness. So this is a determination of wedge shape triangle just now you have seen. And one more important point for the wedge shape film is it is an example of amplitude divisions. And there is a phase condition which is from the top and bottom surface of the thin film or in opposite phase. Overlapping leads to the destructive interference. So this is the condition for why we require the anti-reflection coating. Let us see this complete derivation part in the next class. Thank you. So finally, what we learned today here is in the wedge shaped film, the fringes are straight and parallel, and they are equidistant, and they are localized fringes, and they have the equal thickness, and fringe pattern at the apex point is dark. For any conclusion, please visit the website and give me contact. I given the email ID so that you can discuss with me at any time. Thanks a lot.